Hello and good evening. So today's topic is quite short. It's about federation of cloud. Federation in that context, connecting cloud services from two or more service providers. Let's say, for example, one company may take a service like web service from Amazon, email service from like GoDaddy or some other such provider, and maybe storage from like Google or some other provider. So interconnecting these service providers or cloud services is called the term federation, which we are going to look into this topic. Federation in cloud, like federation, presence, identity, and privacy of cloud. So these are the things we are going to look into today's topic. So there are four levels of federation. One by one, we'll be looking into that. And how the encrypted federation differs or is different from trusted federations and some services and application of federated. And of course, communication federation. So in an overview, the term federation means it's a communication capability in this cloud environment that's capable of supporting the people who are using the cloud, the devices which we use to access to the information feeds of the cloud, documents and other interfaces, everything we are going to look. So in short, it's like connecting everything. So the solution chosen must be able to find the entities, determine their purpose, and the request, the presence data, so that the others can interact with them in the real time. And this presence or this process is known as the term discovery. Providing the discovery information about the availability of the various entities for like the organization, they'll be deploying the real-time services or achievements to significant to their revenue opportunities, like they want to make money through that. So what is cloud federation? Cloud federation is the practice of interconnecting the cloud computing environments of two or more service providers. This is what I have to. The main purpose is to balance the load, the traffic load. So cloud federation requires one provider to a wholesaler or renting computing services. So one will be the primary provider, others will be just using some parts of their services to interconnect with others. And these resources become a temporary or permanent extension of the buyer's cloud computing environment. Federation in cloud, the main challenge is creating and managing a globally centralized cloud computing environment. So today, connecting everything has become connected. Every country has become connected. Companies have become integrated, connected. So we have become a global economy. So a key opportunity for the emerging cloud industry will be in defining a federated cloud ecosystem by connecting multiple cloud computing providers using just a common standard. And Microsoft, they have conducted a research. It's called the Geneva framework that focuses more on how can we maintain the federation of the cloud computing. And they also has come up with claim-based access platforms in cloud computing. So there are many services like we have authentication services to connect with the Active Directory, which is called the LDAPs directories or other native Active Directories. For application-specific databases we have, or InfoCard we have. So over the past few years, the controversy brewing the web service infrastructure. So people have been talking more about the shift of these cloud services to build a collaborative network of services. Collaborative means a group, interconnected ones. So the problem is that the protocols powering these current trend services, which call in simple terms SOAP or Simple Object Access Protocol, and other HTTP, HTTP means hypertext ones, like for the web, the URLs, we have sent hypertext request, right? Like those things. So therefore, the cloud services aren't real-time and won't scale and cannot even afford. So they can't hear the firewall. So we are going to use extensible messaging one. So similar to XML, extensible messaging messaging and presence protocol, XMPP, or it's called a JBoB. It's the protocol that will fuel the software as a service. So at the very first day, we have been learning about SaaS model. So that's the main protocol that driving it. Like big companies like Google, Apple, they are in it. And since the beginning of the internet era, all we wanted is just to synchronize between the servers, one server to other servers. just to have synchronization between them. So poll in, ping in, just it's there to just make that message has been delivered from one server to another. So ping means a request, right? From one server one to server two, we send a request and the request will be sent back as a acknowledgement. So email is also an exchange of documents, something like that. So basically this is how we are going to connect. And of course, connecting one server to another server, we use an interface, application program interface called API. So in the software level, we are using APIs to connect. Some advantages of XMPP, it is decentralized, it's based on open standards, and it's multiple implementers. So there are many clients, there are many servers in this model. Alright, robust security is there because of TLS, transport level layer security, or simple authentications, and it's also very flexible. So whenever you want action, we can. And it's good for cloud computing because it allowed easy two-way communication from client to server. Very easily we can communicate, and it eliminates the need for pooling. So no need to pool or just give a queue. Alright, so just a list of advantages for the real world. And of course, XMPP is not the only pub sub enabler of this web application developers. Amazon EC2, they have come up with their own one, something called Comet. Alright, and unlike the SMPP, the Comet is also based on HTTP and is just a mix of conjunction with the BX protocol to exchange the data. And given the current market penetration or extensive use of XMPP and XCP of the federation of the cloud. So four levels of federation. One is the permissive, verified, encrypted, and trusted federation. This is the different four levels of federation that cloud computing is being practiced today. Permissive. The server will accept a connection from a peer network server without verifying the DNS lookups or anything. Even the digital certificate, they are not going to check. So there's a weakness in this, right? Even though it's in the same network, we have to verify that this is a correct server that is asking for a connection with these two servers. So verified federation means this type of federation occurs when a server accepts a connection from a peer after of the peer has been verified. So we will just go with the verification process. DNS setup, DNS, all of those verify, then accept the connection. That's the difference between encrypted one. Yes, a server accepts a connection from a peer if only it supports the transport layer security. Then only we'll do a, then only we can encrypt the packet that has been transmitted, right? So peer must also have a digital certificate. Even a self-signed one can be accepted in this scenario. An encrypted federation server dial back use the DNS as the basis for verification. Alright, does not provide strong authentication or trusted federations. In the trusted federation, what happened is the server accept a connection from a peer only under the stipulation that the peer support a TLS and the peer can present a digital certificate issued by a root certification. So a known root certificate authority will give, okay, this is a server, this name is this, so we guarantee that it's a legit server. Like that, we have third party, a root certification authority. Right, that's the difference between encrypted and trusted federation. So just a comparison between both. Encryption verified federation serves as a foundation for encrypted federation. It builds on the TLS. Then we have SSL secured layers just covering the top of the HTTP communications. And not all certificates are equal because one can have a self-sign, means I give certificate and I am a correct one. But if someone else says, yes, this party is a correct one, then we have this more trust on them, right? So in the trusted federation scenario, the dialback can be avoided if after using the TLS channel for encryptions. So the server verifying the identity protocols to use the SLS protocol for authentication. And in this scenario, server will dispense the server dialback because the SALs provide strong authentication mode. And S2S federation is a very good start towards real-time communication. So both sender and receivers online and exchange, but with encryption. So it's a very good one. And cloud typically consists of all users, the devices, the services, the application, everything is connected in a cloud. So that's why it's very important to have a trusted connection between or integration between the two servers. So such entities today, like the capabilities of the cloud structures or multi-user chat rooms, other like entities, all right, and finding these entities is called the process of discovery. And XMPP use service discovery to find the aforementioned entities. And discovery protocol enables any network participant to query another entity regarding the identity, capability, and associated entities. And when a participant connects to the network, it also queries the authoritative server for its particular domain about the entities associated with that particular authoritative servers. And in response to a service discovery query, the authoritative server informs the enquirer about the services hosted there. And then we have federated services and applications. And XMPP includes a method for maintaining personal list of other entities known as the roster technology, which enables and keep track of other various entities. And usually these are just list of comprised of other entities that users are more interested to interact with. So there are some concerns that we cannot unfound, like designers of the technologies like XMPP learned from past problems like email systems or incorporated these lessons to prevent like or stop from attacks like spoofing or unlimited binary attachment, this kind of thing. And the use of point-to-point federation will avoid problems that occur with multi-hop federations. And protecting and controlling federated communications using the certification issues by trusted root CES ensure encrypted connections and strong authentications are being used, and employing intelligent servers that has the ability to blacklist and whitelist a foreign service. Thank you. That's all for today's one. Please attend the quiz that I have uploaded in the Moodle. Bye.